Not all animals stay in the same place all year round. In fact, many animals need to go to a new habitat to find food or water, to find mates, have their babies, or find warmer weather to survive. This movement of animals every year is called migration. Migration is a behavioral adaptation that helps animals survive by moving from one type of habitat to another. Some animals travel thousands of miles every year, while others travel shorter distances or to different depths of water or different altitudes of mountains. We see examples of migrating animals in South Dakota every year as winter approaches and as spring arrives. Many of these animals travel to warmer places where they can find food through the winter. Have you ever noticed birds in a V-shape flying south in the fall and north in the spring? These are Canada geese migrating south to a warmer climate for the winter months, then returning north when the weather warms up for the summer. Here at the Butterfly House and Aquarium, we learn about butterflies and ocean animals that migrate. Monarchs journey thousands of miles through the sky, and there are ocean animals who travel thousands of miles by sea. Cownose rays get their name for the way their head looks like the nose of a cow. They live in the Western Atlantic Ocean and Caribbean, from Maryland and Virginia to South America. Cownose rays live in large schools and use their flat teeth to crush the shells of crabs and mussels for food. Cownose rays migrate in groups of up to 10,000 rays. A large gathering of cownose rays is called a feaver. Cownose rays migrate based on the season, traveling south to find warmer waters in the winter, and going north in the summer to habitats where they give birth and find breeding grounds. The cownose rays that live along the coast of the eastern United States migrate between the Chesapeake Bay in Maryland and the Florida coast. These rays return to the bay in May to give birth to their pups in the safety of the bay waters in June. They will mate in July, then migrate south to the Florida coast for the winter. Similarly, another population of cownose rays migrates from the western coast of Florida south to the eastern coast of Mexico and the Caribbean in the fall. The warmer waters near Mexico and the Caribbean provide plentiful food in the winter, and the Gulf of Mexico gives a protected area for the cownose ray pups to be born. The cownose ray migrations are an adaptation to survive, where they move to different habitats to find warm waters and food in the winter. In the spring, they give their pups the best chance of survival by giving birth in safe places like a bay with fewer predators.
The most well-known of insect migrations is the monarch butterfly migration. Monarch butterflies fly nearly 3,000 miles from Canada to Mexico every fall. Just imagine a tiny butterfly that weighs less than a dime flying thousands of miles through wind, rain, cities, and the countryside to reach its final destination. That's incredible. Why would a butterfly take such a challenging journey? For survival. Monarch butterflies have adapted to survive by migrating back and forth between a habitat where they can lay their eggs on milkweed through the summer and a habitat where they will not freeze through the winter. Butterflies are cold-blooded, which means they cannot regulate their own body temperature. The environment around them determines the insect's body temperature. Most butterflies that live in North America can hibernate in their chrysalis form through the winter because they have a substance in their blood that keeps them from freezing. Monarchs do not have that anti-freezing adaptation, so they fly south to survive the winter. Let's go through a year with the monarch butterfly. It's spring in Mexico. The monarchs have been resting in the trees from November until March, saving energy and waiting for it to warm up. There are so many monarchs, the trees are orange. As the temperature gets warmer and the days get longer, the monarchs begin flying north to the southeast United States. This is the first place they will find milkweed plants, where the female butterflies will lay their eggs in April. Milkweed is the only plant that monarchs will lay their eggs on because their caterpillars can only eat milkweed leaves. These butterflies that flew north from Mexico will die after mating and laying their eggs. Their children, the next generation of monarchs, will hatch from the eggs as caterpillars, eat milkweed, change into chrysalids, then emerge as adult monarch butterflies in May. Those monarchs will fly north, further into the United States, live about 4 weeks, lay their eggs, and die in June. Their children, the next generation of monarchs, will continue flying north, live about 4 weeks, lay their eggs, and die in July. In August, this next generation of monarchs, the great-grandchildren of the monarchs that flew north from Mexico, will emerge as adult butterflies. They're much different than their parents and their grandparents and are called the super generation. They are larger and stronger because they will be flying to Mexico. As fall arrives in September, the temperatures are cooling and the days are getting shorter. These are the cues for the monarchs to fly south, some flying for 2 months and 3,000 miles to get to their final destination of the Sierra Madre Mountains in Mexico. Nearly 500,000 monarch butterflies fly south to Mexico from Canada and the United States every year. What's even more amazing is that these butterflies did not learn where to go from their great-grandparents that had made the same journey a year ago. It is a behavioral adaptation that drives the monarchs to migrate south, ensuring their species' survival through the winter year after year. Migration is one way that species have adapted to live in different habitats throughout the seasons of the year. Animals will travel to different areas to find warmer temperatures, mates, better food sources, or safety to give birth or lay eggs. No matter how large or small, on land, in the sea, or in the sky, so many animals use migration as an adaptation to survive.